Hey guys, my name is Fahad and I'm going to make video series on Blazor apps. I'm going to talk about validations, authentication, how you can integrate Google Maps, how you can talk to database, how you can sign in with Google and Facebook. I'm going to talk about everything about Blazor. But before I start my first app, I want to talk about why Blazor apps are so cool. I'm going to backtrack a little bit. So in 2006, Microsoft released ASP.NET. And with ASP.NET, you can have dynamic data on your browser. But to do that, for each and every operation, you have to go to server. And that means you're gonna need bigger servers, you're gonna need more CPUs on your server. So to fix that problem, companies like AngularJS and ReactJS, they started writing open source JavaScript frameworks. And people started using this framework because you can write code in JavaScript and push your code on the browser. That means for each and every request, you don't have to go to server. You can do processing on the browser. But even with these languages, there were problems. Problems like authentication. You don't want to write your authentication code on the browser so people can see your authentication code. And these languages are cool, but they don't have all the features that .NET has. Also, when you first time load these applications, they are kind of slower. And there was slowness issue if you're trying to load these applications for the first time. So to fix all this problem, what .NET did, they released Blazor. And with Blazor, you can push code on the browser and you can write code on the server too. But how does Blazor work? Blazor works with technology of WebAssembly. And WebAssembly is technology which lets you compile high-level languages like C, C++, and lets you deploy it on web server. So what .NET has done is .NET has written .NET runtime on top of WebAssemblies. That means you can push whole .NET runtime on your browser. And that's how Blazor works. Blazor runs on, it runs on .NET and it has WebAssembly associated with it. So your Razor components and your Blazor will talk to DOM and perform all the operations. And that way you can have your code on the browser. But how do you solve the problem of authentication? How do you make your code safer and how do you not let the hackers see your authentication code and decompile your code and rewrite your code? To fix that problem, Blazor released Blazor apps too, Blazor server apps. You can run your Razor components and .NET on your server and your browser can make SignalR connection with the server and perform operations. And that way you can write line of business application. You don't have to be scared of hackers. We're gonna make Blazor server apps. The reason why is because it is released in September 2019 with .NET Core 3 and Blazor WebAssemblies, they haven't shipped yet. So let's get started with our first app. To create your first app, you're gonna need Visual Studio 2019 16.3, and you need to make sure that you have .NET Core 3 installed on your Visual Studio. So to create your first app, you go to File, Project, and select Blazor Apps. When you click on New, next you can create you and select a name. I'm gonna select a proper folder here. I'm gonna select Public Folder, because I want to push this application on GitHub and you can have access to it too. I'm gonna call it Blazor app and click on create. When I click on create, it will ask what kind of template do you want to create. So right now we just have Blazor server apps because Blazor WebAssemblies, they haven't shipped yet, like I mentioned. So when I click on create, Visual Studio will create a Blazor server app for me. Cool. So before I get into these files, I just want to run this and see how it looks like. Cool. So you can run, you can see that our Blazor app is running on the browser. And they have provided these two pages for us. And I'm gonna click on open this developer tool here, click on F12. And you can, I'm gonna click on this button and you can see there won't be any network traffic here. When I click on this button, you can see there is nothing going on in network. That means the code is running on the browser. And when I click on it, you can see there is no reload on the page. I'm gonna refresh this page and show something really cool. So when I refresh the page, you can see that the Blazor Bootstrap is getting loaded, Blazor Server JavaScript is getting loaded, and also it's making a SignalR connection to our server to perform the operations. We're gonna talk more about Blazor apps. What I'm gonna do in my next video, I'm gonna add a page here and trying to show validations. And we're gonna explore everything about Blazor. So yeah, this was Fahad. This is how you can create your first app. Thanks for watching the video. Stay tuned. Bye.